There are news. Don't miss the top 5 latest features of vTESTstudio. Hi, my name is Simone, and in this video, I'm going to show you the top 5 highlights of the latest vTESTstudio version 9. So let's get started. The first highlight is the new XIL binding. The ASAM XIL API is a programming API that allows you to access the system under test from a third-party XIL server, such as the one from DSpace or a proprietary tool. With the new XIL binding, you can easily access the MA port variables via DOS. As you can see here, the relevant variables for the test are defined in a vCDL file that contains certain binding information for the external XIL server to be tested. The test design can now be set up on the abstract DOS. You can easily reuse the test designs for different XIL servers by simply adapting the binding information in the vCDL. There is no need to modify the test design itself. To get started with the new XIL binding, you can use our generator, which queries the available variables from the XIL server and generates the appropriate vCDL file for you. The new XIL binding is also available with the freeware tool Backdoor Test Unit Runner. This gives you the flexibility to run the test in any environment. The second highlight is the new comfort function for parameter files. Let me show you how it works. On the right, you can see the Symbol Explorer, where I select some signals that are relevant for my test. And with just a single drag and drop action, a dedicated parameter is automatically created for each signal dropped. It's fast and easy. As a third highlight, I present you the extended support of DOS in the test commands. You can now use embedded and field data members. Here you can see a use case from the door control demo of vVirtual Target. In the Symbol Explorer, you can find the distributed object door control with some embedded data members that you can comfortably drag and drop onto the predefined test commands. This feature allows you to quickly and easily support virtual ECUs from vVirtual Target for the BSW emulation use case. The fourth highlight gives you even more flexibility in designing your test cases. The migration from VS Code to vTESTstudio becomes easier by the fast import of vTest3 YAML files as a test table. Here you can see a test unit that has been created with our free VS Code extension for test units. The test unit contains a test tree that instantiates test cases from 3 different source files. Over time, as your test unit grows, you may want to use even more test design features like the traceability matrix or the predefined test commands in vTESTstudio. Great! Let's just migrate it to the more powerful tool. The first step is to create a new vTESTstudio project and select the existing vEnvironment YAML as the test environment. Next, I integrate the existing source files that contain the actual test case implementations. This can be done by defining a new library on the existing VS Code folder and linking it to a test unit. Finally, I can import the vTest3 YAML directly from the context menu. As you can see, a regular test table is created and you can start working right away using all the great features of vTESTstudio. The last highlight I'd like to mention is the improved support for your CI workflows in our free add-on for building test units, the Test Unit Build CLI. You can now specify an output directory for the build vTUXE files. And if you are working with a vEnvironment YAML file to describe your system environment, you can also select the scenario to use. These are my top 5 highlights in the vTESTstudio version 9, but there are many more. And we are also constantly working on new features to make your test design task as easy as possible. So stay tuned and contact us to learn more. Don't miss any further feature highlights on vTESTstudio and other vector software tools. Just subscribe to our Vector Tech Tutorial channel and hit the bell.